Jen here. So today we are going to make sweet and sour meatballs. So the other day I was teaching this dumpling class and I have some leftover ground pork. So I was thinking, how can I jazz up this ground pork? So today we are going to make this sweet and sour meatballs. So I prep everything here. I will link the recipe in the notes so you can have them. So what I have are the aromatics, which is garlic, onions, ginger, and then I have some finely cut carrots and bell pepper. And then for the sauce, we're gonna make the sauce for the sweet and sour meatballs. We're just gonna combine everything. But first, let's make our meatballs. So I have everything here and we're gonna combine them. And we are going to bake our meatballs. And then once we stir fry our veggies, add the sauce, then we're gonna add the baked meatballs. Okay, so let's start making the meatballs first. I'm using my hand here to combine everything and make sure that they're all well combined. And then we're gonna form them into little balls and then we're going to bake them. I also have some sriracha, gochujang, and some soy sauce and sesame oil that I'm gonna mix here. And we're just gonna mix everything, make sure they're all incorporated. So here I like to use a baking rack and then I spray them with cooking oil and then I put them on top of the baking sheet pan and then this is where I'm going to line up the meatballs to be baked. So I use a small scoop so that I can have an even size of meatballs and then you're just gonna roll it in between your hands and formable and then there you go and then you just line them up into your baking sheet pan with the baking rack on top. Okay, at this point you're preheating your oven to 375 degrees and then we're gonna bake this for about 35 minutes and or until the inside temperature reaches 160 degrees. So we're gonna make our sauce. We're gonna combine everything. I have chicken stock here. I have palm sugar. If you don't have palm sugar, you can use light brown sugar. I have some rice vinegar, honey, some chili paste, soy sauce, and some cornstarch to thicken our sauce. So let's go ahead and mix everything. So I use a whisk here just to make sure that we combine everything. Make sure that everything is well incorporated. And sometimes the cornstarch stays at the bottom, so just make sure that before you add it to the pan, you stir it again, okay? Look at how our meatballs turned out. They're beautiful and the smell, they smell so good. I wish you guys can smell it. So now we're ready to stir fry our veggies, add our sauce, and once the sauce is thickened, then we can add our meatballs. So let's go ahead and do that. I'm adding the onion into the hot pan and just gonna saute it for a little bit just to get that nice flavor. And then here's our garlic and our ginger. So these are all our aromatics, which smells so good and it releases so much flavor too. And then I'm going to season with a little bit of salt and I use red chili pepper flakes, but you can use just regular ground pepper. And then here's the carrot and the bell pepper. I use half green bell pepper and half red bell pepper so I can get that really nice color. See how red, how orange, and there's a little bit of green there. Now here's the sauce. So I'm gonna add the sauce into the pan and just let it simmer. And once it's simmering, then I'm gonna add the meatballs. And then I'm going to simmer it again for about 2-3 minutes or until everything is well heated. And there you go, that's done. Oh, we're done. So now it's tasting time. This is the best part. So let me see, let me try. There's this meatballs right here, let's see. Okay, now let's taste the sauce, the sweet and sour sauce. Perfect. Okay, so everything really balances out, the palm sugar, the honey, and the rice vinegar. The sweet and sour sauce really brings out that flavor, and it matches the meatballs, that flavors that's in it. So it's so great. So guys, try it and let me know what you think. And if you know family and friends that need help with home cooking, please share this video. And thank you again. I'll see you next time. Bye-bye for now. For more recipes, please visit us at leanbellaskitchen.com. And for this one, just click the link below. Thank you. See you soon.